This is LJ Meyer. Mayor Gregor Robertson and the Vision Vancouver Party promised that they would end street homelessness by 2015. However, it's 2014, and a crisis appears to be gripping the city. There are regular protests against rising SRO rents, gentrification, and homelessness. Homeless people are occupying Oppenheimer Park in Vancouver's downtown east side. And the homelessness in Vancouver is going up. This is the city's graph of the homeless counts from 2005 to 2014. Every 3 years, a count is done across all municipalities in the Metro Vancouver area. And since 2010, Vancouver has been doing its own count every year. The light blue represents the homeless who are indoors. In other words, in shelters, couch surfing, and so on. The dark blue are people sleeping in the street. In 2014, total homelessness hit an all-time peak, and street homelessness is up almost 200% over last year. This chart on page 4 of the preliminary report on homelessness makes Vancouver look bad. Street homelessness in Vancouver was up 249% from 2011, whereas it went down in all the other municipalities except one. So what is going on? The Carnegie Community Action Project published surveys in 2012 and 2013 warning that SRO hotels were becoming unaffordable for people living on social assistance. I asked Gene Swanson, longtime activist with the Carnegie Community Action Project, to explain.
Well, we have the highest homeless count in the city that we've ever had, ever. And there's three reasons for that. One is welfare rates haven't gone up for 7 years, so people don't have enough money to pay rent in other places. The second is that the number of social housing units that are being built is really, really low. It's more like 200 a year compared to 700 or 800 a year in the 80s. And it's getting lower because there's no social housing program going into the future, virtually no social housing program. And then the third thing is the SROs, the single room occupancy hotels, which are the last resort before homelessness, are getting gentrified. Landlords are buying them up, they're putting in a laminate floor and a bar fridge and painting it, and they're renting a room that used to rent for $400 a month for $6 to $8 to $1,000 a month out to young workers and students, and the low income people that used to live in them can't afford them and find themselves on the street.
SRO stands for single room occupancy, which are hotels with single rooms with shared bathrooms. SRO rooms usually rent by the month, and often the buildings are poorly maintained. SRO hotels quite often have mice, cockroaches, bed bugs, and other vermin. However, many poor people rely on them because of their low rents. People on welfare receive $610 a month to live on. $375 goes directly to the landlord, and the remaining $235 is for food and everything else. People on other types of social assistance, such as old age pension, may get more money, but $375 is about a third of their income, which is considered the maximum that they should pay in rent. So they call $375 a month the shelter rate, and it's considered the maximum that people on social assistance should pay in rent. Unfortunately, Vancouver is in the grip of a rental affordability crisis. Even information from the city appears to show it. In 2007, 60% of SROs rented at $375 or less. By 2013, that number was down to just 24%. However, people on social assistance seem to be able to hang on to their SRO rooms at rents higher than $375. But how much higher is debatable.
There's a little figure in the local area plan that says that, according to their information, the average hotel is renting for $450. Our figures say it's $469, but we have a little bit different methods figuring it out. But anyway, $450 is way beyond what a person on welfare can afford.
The second part of the city's graph shows SROs renting between $376 and $450 a month. And the last part of the graph shows the SROs renting over $450 a month. Notice that in 2013, there was an increase of 17% in the number of SROs renting for over $450 a month. That is about 850 units that became totally out of reach for people on income assistance. Also notice that the SROs renting in the $376 to $450 range hit a peak of about 60% in 2011, and then declined to 45% in 2013. This 45% could represent well over 2,000 low-income people in danger of being pushed out of SROs. The city also mentioned that there are about 600 renovated SRO units with very high rents, but it does not say how quickly it expects the number of high-rent SROs to grow over time. Even if welfare recipients can afford the rent, landlords often prefer to rent to students and working poor. Jeffrey Howes, a spokesperson for a company that manages SRO units, explains why.
Buildings, and most of our buildings have some people at the welfare rate, and most of our buildings are now aimed at the working poor or people on low income. Because I have to tell you, from a business standpoint, renting to welfare individuals is truly a lose-lose, because not only do the rooms get destroyed, but there is no revenue to do any kind of repairs and maintenance. And that's not a business model that we're interested in. We're not interested in being a slum landlord.
There is a lot of discrimination against people on welfare. Desk clerks and managers have told our researchers, we're trying to get rid of the bad apples, we're trying to get rid of the welfare people.
So it is possible that people on social assistance are being pushed out of SROs, even if they can pay the rent. The city manager, Penny Bellum, appears to acknowledge in her reports to council that SRO rooms are an issue.
Our SROs are, you know, that's 5,000 plus units of our most affordable housing for low-income residents. They're far from perfect. I think, council, you've heard about a lot of the issues with them, but we need to work really hard to make sure they remain affordable to people on social welfare or a disability pension, where the shelter rate's about $375 a month, and they have to be fit to live in.
But the city does not appear to estimate the impact of people on social assistance being pushed out of SRO hotels.
If you look at street homelessness, we had 538 counted in the 2014 count. If you add a 1% growth, it is what we accept as inevitable. It takes you to 542. If we have our interim and supportive housing units, our winter shelters and our rent subs all come, we could solve street homelessness and take about 230 people, you know, off the total homeless list, which would be a major accomplishment and definitely in the realm of possibility. This is not magical thinking. It will require some resources, but it absolutely can be done.
If SRO affordability is one of the drivers for homelessness, I'm wondering why there is no number shown for how many SRO units are becoming unaffordable to people on social assistance. Another 850 unaffordable SROs, or even another 250, could mess up this result. I had a number of questions for City Manager Penny Bellum, but I could not get her to answer them on or off camera. She asked me to submit a written list of questions to the city's media group, which I did. However, I don't feel that I got satisfactory answers. So why is the city not estimating displacement due to the rising SRO rents? I would be delighted to have an interview with Penny Bellum and get her side of the story.